डियर स्टूडेंट्स, फिगर शोज आ फोर पोल एट स्लॉट मशीन डीसी मशीन. नाउ वी हैव टू प्लेस कंडक्टर्स इन द स्लॉट्स, एट स्लॉट्स शोन इन फिगर, एंड मेक कनेक्शंस टू द कोएलेंट्स टू द कम्यूटेटर सीगमेंट्स सो एज टू फॉर्म अ फुल पिच डबल लेयर progressive simplex lap winding. In previous lecture we have discussed all these terms. What do you mean by full pitch winding and short pitch winding? That is corded winding, we know it. What do you mean by double layer or single layer winding? We know it. What do you mean by progressive or retrogressive? We know it. What do you mean by simplex or duplex or triplex, multiplex winding? We discussed. And what does it mean, lap or wave winding? We know each term. So if it has been asked to connect the coil ends to the commutator segments so as to form a full pitch double layer progressive simplex lap winding, then how we will proceed? Today we are going to discuss it. Just learn the steps, then later on you can design for any, whether progressive or retrogressive, where single layer, double layer, full pitch or simplex or duplex or lap or wave, right? So for double layer winding, yesterday we discussed that number of slots is equal to number of coils, because in double layer winding two coil sides are placed in single slot. Like suppose take any slot, if you are taking this slot, so you will see two coil sides will be placed in a single conductor. That's why the name double layer is given. Fine. At the same time, in double layer winding, one coil side occupies the top position, then the other coil side, suppose this is a coil, let us represent dotted other one, other side is represented by dotted line. So if this is placed at top, then this will be occupy the bottom position of any other slot. Fine. What do we mean by progressive? Full pitch, we know that the coil span will be equal to pole pitch, that is 180 degree electrical. Progressive means the end of, suppose we have commutator segments, right? So we have commutator segments and end is connected to a segment ahead of, suppose this is A, this is B. So we can see that end of this coil is connected to a segment ahead of the segment to which its start is connected. So this is progressive winding. Reverse is there, then that will be retrogressive, right? We know it, right? Simplex, we know that in simplex winding, a single completely closed winding is there. So we have to form simplex, not duplex. In duplex, we know that the alternate segments are occupied by each set of winding, right? So we have simplex, just one set, one completely closed set of winding, simplex winding, right? Lap means overlapping will be there. Means in lap winding, the end of one coil is connected to the start of next coil. Suppose this is one coil, this is another coil. So this end will be connected to the start of another coil. So like this. Fine. And so on, C or D, like that. So we can see that in lap winding, the end of one coil is connected to the start of next coil, and so on. So overlapping of winding is there. That's why the name lap winding is given. Fine. So we have to design our winding considering all these specifications required in the problem asked. Okay, so we have eight coils and eight commutator segments. Just count it. We have eight coils, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Hence, commutator segments 1, 2, 3. Let us mark it. Let us name it. Say this is A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. So we have eight commutator segments corresponding to eight coils. Why eight coils? Because we have eight slots and this is double layer winding. So in double layer winding, number of slots is equal to number of coils. Fine. So let us number the coils. So starting from this, let us say this is conductor number one, sorry, coil side one. Coil may not necessarily be single turn, multi turn also. So let us start numbering one coil side as one. So if one coil side of a coil is placed, so if this is placed in this slot, then this will be placed 180 degree electrical apart so that the coil spin will be equal to 180 degree electrical, hence the name full pitch coil will be given. So how to put the other coil side 180 degree electrical? So this is four pole machine. So four pole machine, one pole pitch, yesterday we defined that one pole pitch is nothing but the peripheral displacement, angular displacement. It is better to say angular displacement in electrical degree from two consecutive, between two consecutive poles, or distance between two identical points on two adjacent poles. So take any identical point. If you are taking center, so this center, so from this center to this center, it will give one pole pitch. So it is mechanical 90 degree. But number of poles are 4, hence electrical degree will be equal to 4 by 10 into 90, that is 180 degree electrical. So if you are taking from center, take from center, or if you are taking from here, so you will take till here, means from here till here, it will give a span of one pole pitch. On the other way, you know that total mechanical degree is 360 degree, and we have 8 slots, or we have four poles and eight slots. So slots per pole will be 8 by 4, that is 2, means 2 slot per pole, and one pole pitch is a span of one pole, that is 180 degree electrical, and 2 slot corresponds to one pole, it means one slot corresponds to 90 degree. So from here till here, the span will be 90 degree electrical. I am talking about electrical. And from here to here 90, and then again 90. So this will be 180 degree electrical. So there are lots of ways to get the pole pitch starting from any point in the machine, on the rotor of machine. So if our one coil side is placed here, so other coil side will be placed 180 degree apart, that will be 90 plus 90, means here. So place it here and name it one dash. One dash means dotted one, other coil side. So in, suppose this is one dash. So this will be two and this will be two dash. So in lap winding, we can observe that, let us say one is connected with A. Okay. So let us connect this one with A. And before that, just place the brushes. So for four pole machine, we have our magnetic neutral axis as this and this. So for this, four brushes will be required. So let us place the brushes at their positions. So brushes are placed along magnetic neutral axis. So one pair of brushes will be placed here This is magnetic neutral axis, and one set of brushes, one pair of brushes will be placed along this magnetic neutral axis. Let us make it like this. And here also. So we have placed four brushes along the two magnetic neutral axis for this four pole machine. So one coil side is placed connected to commutator segment A, then end will be connected to the next of this commutator segment, because this is simplex lap winding. If it would be duplex, then we have to leave one commutator segment for the other set of winding in case of duplex. Similarly, in case of triplex, we need to leave two segments for the other two sets of completely closed windings in case of triplex. But in simplex, no need to worry. So the other coil end will occupy the next commutator segment. So other coil side is one, and let us represent it by dotted. So this is occupying A, so this will occupy B. So let us represent it by dotted line. So we have connected one. Now in lap winding, the end of one coil is connected to the start of the next coil. Next coil is second coil. So second coil is, let us mark the coils first. So okay, let us mark it 2. So here first mark 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We have 8 coils, and let us show the conductors in each slot. Two coil sides are there. Each circuit represents one coil side, and one coil side is having a number of conductors insulated from each other. Okay, so this is the other coil side of this. So now the next two is connected with the start of two is connected with the end of first coil, that is B segment. So a start will be connected with this. Now end will lie full pitch winding. For full pitch winding, the coils are having full pitch. So from 90 and 90 we have seen, so this will be 2 dash. So let us mark first. Similarly for 3, this will be 3 dash, 4, this will be 4 dash, and 5 dash, a span will be 180 degree, other coil side. So if 6 is lying here, so 6 dash will lie here, 6 dash, 7 dash, and this will be 8 dash. Fine. So end of this will be connected to the start of the next. So a start of the next will be, this is B, so this will be a start. A start, and this is the end. So let us use black color for the other coil sides. To distinguish between the connections. Fine. So 2 is connected, see, one end is connected with A, 2 is connected with B, 3 connected with C, and with C, end of second coil is connected. Now connect the end of third coil. So this is this. So this will be connected with, so end of third coil will be connected with the start of the fourth coil. So a start of the fourth coil is commutator is connecting these two coil sides. Fine. Now end of fourth coil, that is this, is connected with the start of fifth coil. So this is end of fourth coil, and this will be connected with the start of fifth coil. We can see that in lap winding, end of one coil is connected with the start of the next coil. So we are till here. Now end of fifth coil, which is this, is connected with the start of next coil, that is sixth coil. So end of this coil will be connected with the start of sixth coil through this commutator segment. Now end of sixth coil, this will be connected with the start of next coil, that is seventh coil. Now end of seventh coil, that is this, will be connected with the start of eighth coil. So let us connect here the same segment. End of seventh coil will be connected with the start of eighth coil. So end of eighth coil, this one will be connected with the start of the next coil, and next coil will be one, that is this one. So let us connect it here with A. Fine. So we have connected, we have eight coil only. So we have already discussed that this is used to be a completely closed winding. It means the end of last coil will be connected with a start of first coil. So end of the last coil, that is eighth coil, eight dash, will be connected with the start of first coil. So we have completely closed winding. Let us draw develop diagram to understand it better. So let us make a cut from here and first represent the slots. So the slots may be represented like, okay, start from here. Second slot, third slot, fourth slot, fifth slot, sixth slot, seventh, eighth, and again represent it here, the first one. Let us show the coil sides. Two coil sides of different coils placed in each slot. And let us mark the numbers. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and again we have represented the first one here. Fine. And the other coil sides placed at the bottom positions of the slots. So this is 7 dash, then 8 dash, 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash, 4 dash, 5 dash, 6 dash, and then 7 dash. The same slot is again represented there. Fine. In practice, first the bottom positions are occupied. It means just the other end of seventh is placed here, other end of eighth is placed here, other end means second coil end is placed here, So once the bottom positions are occupied, then the top positions are being occupied while winding for DC machine. Fine. So we know that these coil sides are placed along the slots cut on the outer periphery and parallel to the shaft, right? So we know that our conductors coil sides are like these and so on for everyone, right? So let us represent these coil sides here. So this is our coil side one, and let us represent the bottom one by dotted line. Dotted line. So similarly for let us draw with me on your notebook, practice it here itself. So this is one, I am writing at the top for the top coil sides, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, again 1, fine. Now for bottom one, just I am writing here, this is 7 dash, and again this is 8 dash, here this is 1 dash, this is 2 dash, this is 3 dash, this is 4 dash, 5 dash, 6 dash, and again the same 7 dash. Fine. Now make the connections. Make the connections. So first connect one with one dash. One coil side of coil one is here and one dash is here. So connect this is one is connected with one dash, as we know these are the part of one coil. One coil side is one, other coil side is one dash. Now in one dash is connected with two, see here, one dash is connected with two, a start of two, end of first coil is connected with the start of two. This is conducting part, commutator segment B. Fine. So connect this. So this will be, where is one dash? This is one dash. So one dash will be connected with two. So let us connect this. Fine. Now two will be connected with two dash. So connect with this. And end of second will be connected with the start of the third. So this will be connected with the start of. Again, this 3 and 3 dash will be connected. So connect with me. And end of third, 3 dash will be connected with the start of fourth. So this is a start of fourth. And 4 will be connected with 4 dash. And the end of 4 will be connected with the start of 5th, and 5 will be connected with 5 dash, and end of 5 will be connected with a start of 6, and 6 will be connected with 6 dash, एंड एंड ऑफ सिक्स विल बी कनेक्टेड विद द स्टार्ट ऑफ सेवन, सेवन विल बी कनेक्टेड विथ सेवन डैश, एंड सेवन डैश विल बी कनेक्टेड विथ ए स्टार्ट ऑफ एट. सो दिस इज ए स्टार्ट ऑफ एट, एंड एट विल बी कनेक्टेड विथ एट डैश. सो लेट अस मेक हियर, एंड दिस विल गो टू एट डैश. फाइन, एंड एट डैश इज हियर द सेम वी हैव रिप्रेजेंटेड दिस. सो दिस इज एट डैश, एंड एट डैश विल बी कनेक्टेड विथ एंड ऑफ द लास्ट वन स्टार्ट ऑफ द फर्स्ट वन. सो दिस विल बी कनेक्टेड विथ दिस वन. सो दिस वे वी हैव अ क्लोज्ड, कंप्लीटली क्लोज्ड वाइंडिंग. Progressive, simplex, double layer, lap winding. Fine. Now we can observe that at this moment of time, these two slots are lying under North Pole. So let us mark these poles. So these two slots are having conductors 1, 2 and 7 dash 8 dash. Means 1, 2, 7 dash 8 dash. Means these are lying under North Pole, and these 3, 4, 1 dash, 2 dash, these are lying under South Pole. So let us mark the poles. At this moment, these rotors are rotating, changing the positions. So we are talking about this moment. So 5 and 6, next again North Pole, and the next 7, 8, South Pole, and again next North Pole, this one, one dash already shown, North Pole. So alternate North-South pole arrangement is there. Now we can rotate our rotor either in clockwise or anti-clockwise by any prime mover, by means of any prime mover. So let us take any direction, let us take anti-clockwise, let us take, we are rotating our rotor in anti-clockwise direction with a speed omega. So we can get the polarities corresponding to this rotation. So this is the direction of, let us take any conductor, conductor number one. So for this anti-clockwise rotation, the velocity at this moment will be in this direction, tangential to this. Let us say this is V, and for north, this is V, direction of B. Basically, this will have 90 degree. Here the direction will be like this, right? We have discussed in our previous lectures. So we want to get the direction. So direction we may get from Fleming's right hand rule or a screw rule. So V cross B, so movement of this pin is out of the plane. Out of the plane means dot here. So dot here. So for this, the direction of B is opposite to this. So hence cross here. Cross here, cross here, cross here. Again, for north, opposite, so dot here, dot here. Wherever north is there, dot. Wherever south is there, cross. If we will change the direction of rotation, so we will be changed, so we will get the opposite polarity, right? Now, if we have connected load across the output terminal, so current will flow. So represent the direction of currents. So for this, these ends are connected to commutator segments. So these are the front end, that is commutator end. These are the back end. So dot means towards the commutator segments. So directions can be marked like this, towards the commutator segment. Dot means towards. Here we will, okay, we will make commutator segments. Okay, let us make the segments. Fine. We will make the commutator segments later. So these are commutator ends. So directions will be like this. So here cross are there towards, it means away from commutator segments. Cross means into the plane, dot means out of the plane. So out of the plane, and these are commutator segments. So directions will be like this. If we will reverse the direction of rotation of rotor with the help of prime mover from anti-clockwise to clockwise, then these directions will be reverse. We know it better. Again, downward, 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 upward, 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 downward, downward here, right? Now, show the brush positions on the commutators. So, we have one magnetic neutral axis in between two poles, this one. So, let us represent this A. So, A segment is here, and let us represent first the brushes. So, we have represented one brush here, A, then again next brush along this magnetic neutral axis. So, after this, this is the next magnetic neutral axis. So, represent one brush position here. And next magnetic neutral axis, the third brush position, and next the fourth brush position. Let us draw with me. So this is A. So this, at this moment of time, this commutator segment C touches the this brush. So let us C and E. And this is touching G. Brushes are stationary parts and commutator segments are moving. So at this moment of time, these segments are touching the four brushes. That's why we have represented. So let us represent the other one, B, D, not touching any brush. It. And in between, we have mica insulations. We know it as we already discussed in our previous lectures. So, represent these insulations, mica insulations. Fine. So, before this is H. So, this is H. So, after H, A is there. So, let us represent H here also. Fine. Now, we are going to connect. One is connected with commutator segment A. So, let us connect one with A. Two is connected with B. Three is connected with C and so on. So, let us connect. Let us verify it. Connections. So we have connected all coilants with the commutator segments. The same H is represented here, right? After that, again, A can be shown. If required, we can show it. Fine. So let us verify it. Let us take anyone. So fourth is connected with D. Let us search for fourth. Okay, four is connected with D. Right, let us take seven. Seven is connected with G. So seven is connected with G. Fine. So we have made the connections. So we can see that the direction of current in this segment is this. Coming from here, right? We can see that this way currents are coming. Fine. Again, in this direction of current is this. Here the direction is downward at this moment of time, and here direction is upward. Wherever brushes are there to collect the current, we can show the directions at all the four positions. So if load will be connected to this, so it will supply current. Fine. This will also supply current, and this will. So we can observe that we have two positive terminals and two negative terminals. So let us connect these terminals positive together. During construction also we have shown these connections alternate. We had taken the example of four pole machine, and there also in very first lecture we have shown the four brushes and two brushes connected together, right? So you can understand it better now. And let us connect it. So we have two terminals, one is positive terminal and one is negative terminal. And if a load is connected in between, then current will start flowing like this. So this will be the direction of current. Current is coming from here, and here current is coming from here, here, and current is leaving here. Current is also leaving here. So current is leaving here and here. We can cross check the directions. Fine. Directions. Now let us make these brushes somewhere else. Okay, I am omitting here. Let us draw it here. So let us make positive terminal this brush somewhere here, positive one, and load is connected with positive one. So let us make load, show load here. So we can see that one terminal is connected with these two positives. So let us represent this positive here. This is also positive terminals, and these two terminals are connected together, and this is connected with one end of this load. Fine. So this is the direction. Fine. We will see later. And let us represent the negative terminals. Negative, negative, and these two terminals are connected together. This is negative, this is negative, right? And the other end of this load is connected with this. So what is the direction? So this is minus. So this is the direction of current through this. Now let us start from this. So we have taken this as, let us say, 1 2 3 4, brush number 1 2 3 4. So this, okay, just mark it for our convenience. Let us mark the brush number 1 2 3 4. We have marked the brushes to distinguish here. So this is brush number 1, let us represent. Then negative 1, this is 2. Then again positive 1, this is brush number 3. And then again fourth one, दिस इज ब्रश नंबर फोर. ओके सो स्टार्ट फ्रॉम एनी से फ्रॉम टू. सो वी आर स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम टू. सो फ्रॉम टू द करेंट डायरेक्शन कैन बी ऑब्जर्व एज लेट अस टेक दिस वन पाथ. सो वी कैन से टू डैश फ्रॉम स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम दिस ब्रश नंबर टू. दिस इज टू डैश टू देन वन डैश वन एंड टू ब्रश नंबर वन. सो फ्रॉम टू वी हैव फोर क्वाइल साइड्स. दीज क्वाइल साइड्स आर टू डैश टू. सो लेट अस मेक दीज क्वाइल्स. ओके वी हैव फोर क्वाइल्स क्वाइल साइड्स and these are starting from brush number 2 2 dash then 2. So mark it here 2 dash 2 then from 2 this is 1 dash and then 1 1 dash 1 and we have come to this right. So after this let us take the next path. From the same brush we have two paths. So this path has been taken. The other path will be one dash, not one dash, this is three. So other path is three, three dash, then four, four dash, and goes to brush number three. So brush number three is here. So starting from two, the other path is in between brush number two and three. So we have again four coil sides. So let us make four coil sides here. And this coil side is connected. These coil sides are connected between brush number 2 and 3. How? Starting from brush number 2, we have taken this path. So just mark with me. So this is 3, 3 dash. Starting from 2, this is 3. 3 dash, 3 dash, then because no current will flow here because these are insulations, mica insulations, so no path through this. So 3 dash, then 4 and 4 dash, then brush number 3, 4, 4 dash and then brush number 3. So we have taken the two parallel paths between this negative terminal to the positive terminals. Now start from the other negative point, this negative terminal. So 4, this is 4. So starting from 4, let us take anyone. So this is 6 dash. So 6 dash 6, then this is 5 dash and 5, then brush number 3. So again we can observe that we have 4 coil sides connected between brush number 4 and 3. So starting from 4 we have 6 dash, then 6, just mark it, 6 dash 6, 6 dash 6, then this is 5 dash and 5, and finally till brush number 3. So 5 dash 5 and we have reached till brush number 3. We can cross check again. Fine. So let us take the other path. We have two parallel paths. We have covered this 6 dash path through 6 dash. Now we will take this other path. This is through 7. So starting from this brush number 4, this is 7, then 7 dash, then 8 and to 8 dash. Where is 8 dash? This one. And then brush number 1. So again we have 4 coils, coil sides so starting from this 4 dash these coil sides are 7, 7 dash, just mark it here. So this is 7, 7 dash स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम दिस सेवन, सेवन डैश, देन एट, एट डैश, देन दिस इज एट, दिस इज एट डैश, सो एट डैश, वेर इज एट डैश, दिस इज एट डैश, राइट, दिस इज एट डैश एंड इट इज गोइंग टू ब्रश नंबर वन, सो दिस इज कनेक्टेड विथ ब्रश नंबर वन. सो दिस वे वी कैन ऑब्जर्व दैट वी हैव अ कंप्लीटली क्लोज्ड वाइंडिंग. हाउ? स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम क्वाइल नंबर वन, सो क्वाइल नंबर वन इन सीरीज विद द अदर क्वाइल साइड, एज वी नो, वन वन डैश एंड इन सीरीज विद द क्वाइल टू, टू टू डैश, देन अगेन थ्री थ्री डैश, फोर फोर डैश, फाइव फाइव डैश, सिक्स सिक्स डैश, देन सेवन सेवन डैश, एट एट डैश एंड देन अगेन वन. सो स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम वन वी हैव कंप्लीटेड द पाथ, सो दिस वाइंडिंग इज अ कंप्लीटली क्लोज्ड वाइंडिंग. फाइन. सो दिस वे द लोड्स आर कनेक्टेड बिटवीन दीज टू टर्मिनल्स, लेट अस मार्क, एंड दिस करेंट इज कॉल्ड आर्मेचर करेंट रिप्रेजेंटेड बाई आई ए. सो दिस आई ए इज बींग कंट्रीब्यूटेड बाई हाफ फ्रॉम दिस साइड आई ए बाई टू एंड हाफ फ्रॉम दिस साइड आई ए बाई टू एंड दिस आई ए बाई टू इज कंट्रीब्यूटेड बाई हाफ फ्रॉम दिस साइड हाफ फ्रॉम दिस साइड, दिस इज आई ए बाई टू, सो दिस इज, और यू मे रिप्रेजेंट लाइक दिस आई ए बाई फोर, दिस इज आई ए बाई फोर. वाई फोर? बिकॉज वी हैव फोर पैरेलल पाथ्स. वाई फोर पैरेलल पाथ्स? दिस इज लैप वाइंडिंग एंड वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस दैट इन लैप वाइंडिंग number of parallel paths is equal to number of poles and our machine was 4 pole machine. So if you will take 6 pole machine, the parallel paths will be 6. You can draw it at in your notebook. If you wish, you can mark it as your home assignment. Let us draw for 6 pole and 8 pole boards, right? If you wish, you can draw it. Fine. So the main point is the number of poles P will give you the number of parallel paths. Here we are getting 4 parallel paths because we are having 4 pole. Fine. So that's why the current in each parallel path will be IA by 4. That is, current rating is reduced. Fine. In each parallel path. So we can use such type of machines where high rating are required because the burden of current on each coil will be reduced depending upon the number of parallel paths. We are having 4 parallel paths, so 1/4 of this current will be required here and accordingly the insulations required will be reduced. Fine. Now if some brush is damaged, not working, what will happen? We can't collect the current through that brush. See, this current can be collected through this brush only. This can't be collected through these brushes because of these insulations in between. We are not having any paths. Fine. So the same 4 parallel paths can be represented like this. So let us represent this brush, one positive terminal, one again positive terminal here and one negative to simplify it and one negative here. Simplify. So let us represent it separately. these we are representing these, right? These in between. So this is one positive, let us mark here. Then second one negative, let us take second one here or here, anywhere we can take. Okay, let us take second one here. So this is negative. Then again in between these two, this coil is connected, 1 1 dash 2 2 dash is connected. We have represented together the four coil sides connected together. So we have represented by a single winding. Then again positive, this one 3. So this is 1, this is 2, this is 3, brush number 3, and this is brush number 4, right? So 3 is positive, 4 is negative. So let us mark here negative. And these two positive are connected together. So let us connect these two positives together. And these two negatives are also connected together. So let us connect these two together. And we have our load here. So this positive terminal, this is positive and this is negative terminal. So we can represent our currents here IA and here the directions like this. So here the current will be IA by 2, here also IA by 2 from positive terminals. This is coming from here. So in coils the currents will be IA by 4 in each coils, in each coil, right? Similarly this is IA, so this will be IA by 2. Here also IA by 2, and this IA by 2 will split into two parts, IA by 4, IA by 4. Suppose if any brush is damaged as discussed just now, few minutes before. So as we have discussed that, if this is damaged, then this current can't be collected. Can be collected by any other brushes. So don't be confused that if these are shorted then we have these connections and we can be collected, right? No current can be collected accordingly. If this brush is shorted, so this current can't be collected by any other brushes. We will see with the help of one numerical problem asked in gate exam in next class, right? So hope this is clear to you. If you have any doubt, just write in the comment. Thank you very much for today's lecture.